To start up with tubular knitting on any of the Singer type knitting machines, that includes Silver Reed, Studio, Elna, Knitmaster, Toyota has the bulky that's the same as this, and this should be the same for the standard machines because the carriages are very similar. You're going to bring out your needles. Well, before you do that, you're going to set your racking indicator to any H setting. I have mine on H3. I have 30 needles out on the knitter, 30 needles out on the ribber. I believe the manual tells you to have one needle on the end, whether it's the ribber or knitter, and it really doesn't matter. You don't have to worry about that. On the knitter carriage, you're going to have your cam set to stockinette and also the tension dial to R. On the ribber carriage, you're going to have your cam to the O here, which is stockinette, or actually rib, but you're going to have the tension dial to R. You put your yarn in the connecting arm here in between the two beds, knit across one row, and it does a zigzag row. This is your cast on. Next, you're going to put your ribber comb on. And I like to put my thumb and finger on that middle hole and then line that up with the zero. When you get that in place, you're going to thread the wire through the teeth of the ribber comb. Then I've seen some patterns say not to hang your barrel weights as of yet. I've always done that. It really doesn't matter. As long as you don't have too many weights on it, you're going to be fine. Next, I look at where the yarn is, the last needle, which happens to be the knitter. So I want to set the first tubular row to start working on the ribber needles. So first, I'm going to set up the ribber carriage. Because I want it to knit here first, I'm going to leave, this is the side lever, that's the Russell lever. When you look at the levers of the knitter carriage, you got the 1 and 2, which is on the front or on the side. Those are the Russell levers, so this is the side levers. Next, I want to take the left side, put it up to 0. And because I put the left side lever on the ribber carriage up to 0, I need to take the right side lever on the knitter carriage and bring it forward. But because I want it to skip or slip this first row, I also need to put the cam here to slip. Now I have my carriages already set up to do tubular. If I was to do rib, I would put my side lever here on the knitter carriage back. I would put the cam back to stockinette and the left side lever on the ribber carriage back to 1, and then it would be the rib. Of course, it would be full needle rib with this. But this is how you start out tubular knitting. And then once you get those first tubular rows done, that's all there is to it. Now in the manual, it states to slip your cam on the knitter from slip to knit. I would be slipping from left to right, and I would knit from right to left. But because the side lever over here is forward, it's doing the slip. Because the left side lever is back, that's normal knitting. And that's all there is to tubular knitting. Now, if this is a scarf, you're going to want to close off that last end. The first end is already closed off. So what I would do in this case is I would take the stitches off the ribber, transfer them to the knitter needles, and then I would do a bind off. You could knit one row. If you're going to be putting fringe on it, it's going to be hidden. But that one row, depending on what yarn size you're using and what tension dial you have it set to, may look a little off. So, you know, try it both ways. See which way you like it.